Appetite for Destruction was a turning point for hard rock in the late 80s. It was a dirty, dangerous, and mean record in a time where rock and roll meant nothing but a good time. It's one of my all-time favourite albums, and it has some unforgettable musicianship on it. While Slash and Axl usually take the spotlight, a lot of the band's timeless songwriting and bluesy style come from another source. Of course, I'm talking about Mr. Steven Adler, definitely one of the most powerful driving forces behind the band. Okay. The video is about Izzy Stradlin. In this video, we'll cover what gear Izzy was known to have used, and then we'll talk about which gear can produce similar results. You don't need to be playing with the exact same gear as your favourite players. You might have exactly what you need lying around. So let's get into it. Izzy's known to have used Gibson Les Pauls, as well as many different versions of Gibson's ES series. The ES series are semi-hollow body guitars with the exact same pickup setup as the Les Paul, two humbucker pickups. If you happen to have a Les Paul, an ES-135, 155 or 175, then that'll be ideal. However, I don't have any of these guitars, so I'm going to be using my Les Paul knockoff by Fret King. Thankfully, we have our good friend Mr. Capitalism on our side, so you can actually sound quite a lot like Izzy without even giving a single penny to Gibson. There are many brands making very, very good similar guitars. So if you want one, I suggest you shop around. Stick to the bridge pickup of your guitar and use a thicker guitar pick, because you're going to be doing a lot of hard down picking, and without a thick pick, it's going to make things very difficult. Izzy's preferred amp types include the Mesa Boogie Mark series, the Fender Bassman heads, and of course, the Marshall, which is of course what I'm going to be playing out of today. Every Marshall amp comes with an inbuilt overdrive unit, and if you adjust the gain to around 8 o'clock with the mids boosted a little bit, it's already going to sound very, very close. However, if you don't own a Marshall amp, there are other ways you can create a distortion sound to make up for it and tweak it to sound like Izzy.
Izzy, were you going to say something then?
No.
Now, Izzy's guitar sound does vary from song to song on the album. There are times where he sounds very similar to Slash, and then other times where he's more dialed down. For this reason, ideally, I think that you should use a combination of amp distortion and an overdrive pedal, just to give it a little bit of a boost when necessary. Using this setup, I like to keep the tone dial at around 10 o'clock and then adjust the drive as appropriate for the song. If you're using a clean amp signal, however, I don't think that an overdrive pedal will fully cover it, and that you should add a distortion pedal if you can. Using this setup, I like to keep my overdrive settings the same as before, and on my distortion pedal, adjust the tone to around 1 o'clock and the drive to around 9 o'clock. Always use your ear. Listen to the sound of the guitar on the song, listen to your guitar sound, and don't be afraid to experiment and tweak with whatever you have at your disposal. I hope you enjoyed today's video and found it helpful. If you think I missed anything important about Izzy's guitar sound, feel free to let me know in the comments. Also, if there's a guitar player you want me to cover in one of these videos, feel free to let me know. I do actually teach the guitar one-to-one, so if you'd be interested in having a lesson, you can actually book a lesson through my website in the description. If you want to see more videos from me where I talk about guitar playing, you're going to want to press that big red throbbing subscribe button below. I'll see you next time.